Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum to everyone. Welcome in the camp poster with the second lecture of the 9th class with the Dear Shehzadi. Okay, let's get towards our second lecture. That was the fundamental chemistry. In this lecture, we are only discussing some few definitions about the elements. Its older definition, its modern definition, its properties, its occurrence, its benefits, its bonding, etc. And as well as we will learn about the compounds and the mixtures. And we will only compare the compounds with the mixtures and also compare three types: elements, compound and the mixture. So let's start with the elements. Elements were considered like the tiny or the smallest substances that can't be divided. Okay, that was just assumed in the early days. Okay, and now the modern definition is what the element is: a substance is a type substance or a type of a substance that is made up of the atoms having the same atomic mass. You know the atomic mass now, and can't be divided or decomposed into its simple component or substances by the ordinary chemical means. Ordinary chemical means mean ye hai ki iske andar jo chemically hum iske stress whatever we are dividing it. Okay, and it means that each element is made up of the unique type of the atoms and that have the very specific properties like the its valency, its covalent bonding attention, or its electronegativity, its bonding strength, or etc. There are so many properties of any element. And in the older days, that was what was the assumption about the elements and what was its proper definition. That was the it was considered that the element were substances that couldn't be broken down into the simple units by the ordinary chemical means. Means ये था कि इसको chemically जो है ना कोई भी इसका जो आम से chemical का कोई भी means होगा उसको कोई भी source को use करके आप इसको divide नहीं कर सकते. Okay, and for example हम इसको लें तो early days में क्या थे कि only 9 elements was like considered to be elements, like what were included. It's include the carbon, gold, silver, tin, mercury, lead, copper, iron and the sulfur. The only these were the 9 elements that were known in the early days. But in the 16th century there were the 63 elements that were considered to be elements, but now these are the 118 elements and the 92 elements are such elements that are the naturally occurring elements. On the basis of the properties, kya tha ki metals were divided into the different categories, such like metals have na high melting point and the boiling point. Non-metals ke andar jo bhi unki bonding ratio kam hoti hai, and metalloids are also in the less in the melting point as well as the boiling point. About the 80% of the elements were considered like they are the metals. Indeed, they are metals and they are the radioactive hoti hai. Inki electro jo negativity hoti hai, wo high hoti hai. Melting point, boiling point inki high hoti hai, and etc. Okay. And there were also some properties like the elements were considered in a three forms. They could be exist in the gas form, in the liquid form, as well as the solid form. And they have the most probability in ki stability hai, that is in the form of the solid. They are mostly abundant in the form of the solids, then liquids, and then the gases. Gases are, what are the gases? Oxygen, organ, nitrogen, chlorine and the hydrogen, these are in the gases form. And in the solid form ke andar inke andar kya hote hai ki sodium, copper and zinc, gold, etc. These are the elemental forms of the solids. Okay na? Okay, we are now representations properties. Okay, representations means what is the sample of the presentation of a element. If you are representing a element, you have to select a symbol that will explain its identity, that gives its identity and explain its properties. Okay, sample is taken from the Latin word or the Greek or the German words, and if the sample should be the can comes from the two letters. The first letter should be always the capital, Like the hydrogen, it's contain the only single letter, so it's a capital letter H. And nitrogen for the N, it represents the N. And carbon is represented by the carbon like C. In a cases of the two letter symbol, only the first letter is capital, like the calcium Ca, calcium, and the sodium in a Ca, and the chlorine is Cl. Okay, the unique properties of the element is velocity. Iski jo hogi sabse jo main property hai na, ek element ki, its valency. Valency is a capacity of an element to combine to bond with the another element. It depends upon the number of unpaired electrons in the outermost shell, that is also called the valence shell. In the simple covalent bond, the valency is the number of the hydrogen atom which combines to the with one atom that of the element, are the number of the bonds formed by one atom of that element. The valency of the chlorine. A chlorine, nitrogen and carbon, they contain the valency. Chlorine 7, iske outermost shell mein electrons honge, to it's required only of one electron. Oxygen has 6, so it's required the 2. Nitrogen has 3, means it has a isko octet complete karna hota hai na. Octet complete karne ke liye kya hota hai ki valence shell ke andar 8 electron ho. So nitrogen ke andar jo honge hame 8 complete karne ke liye humne isko 5 ke sath isko 3 iske unpaired electron hai na to isko it will gain the 3 electrons like a 3 hydrogen atom isse attach ho jayenge then it will be stable or complete its octet. And carbon is the unique element that has a 4 valency and its कैटिनेशन के अंदर इसको यूज कर रहे हैं इसकी वैलेंसी इसको यूनिक कर ही इसीलिए रहा है कार्बन से हम ग्रेफाइट बनाते हैं कार्बन से हमारे डायमंड बन रहे होते हैं कार्बन से हमारे क्रिस्टल फॉर्म्स होती हैं एंड सो मेनी प्रॉपर्टीज दैट आर ओनली एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय द कार्बन एटम सम एलिमेंट्स शो द मोर देन वन वैलेंसीज ओके वैलेंसीज के अंदर क्या चक्कर होते हैं कि इनके अंदर जो फेरस और फेरिक की एग्जाम्पल हम लेते हैं कि अगर वी आर यूजिंग द फेरिक सल्फेट फेरिक एफ ई एस ओ फोर होता है और एफ ई एस ओ फोर जो होता है इसको अगर हम ना ट्राइज कर दें देन इट अ फेरिक फेरस और फेरिक के अंदर क्या है कि वैलेंसी का चक्कर है इफ द फेर एफ ई यू नो ना इट्स अ सैंपल ऑफ द आयरन आयरन इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय द एफ ई एंड इट्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द फेरस इट्स हैज द वैलेंसी ऑफ द टू एंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द फेरिक इट हैज द वैलेंसी ऑफ द थ्री गॉट इट एंड देयर आई एक्सप्लेन द 20 एलिमेंट्स विद देयर एटॉमिक नंबर्स And these were the first 20 elements in the history. Now come towards the compounds. Compound is a substance made up of the two or the more element chemically bonded together with a fixed ratio by the mass. Mass ke saath uski ek fixed ratio honi chahiye like this. If we are making the water, there should be the two elements na, oxygen and hydrogen. There will be definitely a proper a specific ratio that is the chemically ratio na. Between the oxygen and hydrogen that will make it to the towards the combination and they will form the water molecule. This combination ke andar kya hoga ki this when the two elements combine their original properties lost and they produce a new product new thing with their different properties. Or the compound cannot be broken down into their constituent elements by the simple physical method. We can't divide them. By the physical method, if we are using the chemical methods, then we can break down them into their constituent elements. For example, the carbon dioxide is formed when the element of the carbon and the oxygen combine chemically in a fixed ratio of the 12 ratio with the 32. Okay, 12 we will take the 12 part of the carbon and the 32 part will be of oxygen. And इसको मोर फर्दर सिंप्लीफाई करें तो ये बन जाएगा 3:1 दैट इज द बाय द मैस मैस के अकॉर्डिंग जो होगा इसको हम अगर डिवाइड करते हैं देन इट्स इट विल बी द रेशियो बिटवीन 3:8 ऑफ द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड सिमिलरली द वी टेक द वाटर कंपाउंड इज केमिकली कंबाइंड विद हाइड्रोजन एंड ऑक्सीजन इन अ फिक्स रेशियो ऑफ द 1:8 बाय द मैस रेशियो ऑफ द 1:8 ऑफ मैस ओके लेट्स मूव टूवर्ड्स द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द कंपाउंड Also, the like the elements have the properties. So as well as the compound also have the properties. Any compounds don't exist in the independent form. Okay, it's a first property. They will not exist in independent form. Okay, element can exist. Hydrogen can exist in the form of molecular form. It will exist in a O2 और H2 ऑक्सीजन की फॉर्म में होगा एंड क्लोरीन कैन इट्स इंक्लूडेड इन टू द फॉर्म ऑफ द रेडिकल्स बट ऑल्सो सम एक्सटेंट इट्स कैन एग्जिस्ट इन इंडिपेंडेंट फॉर्म. दे फॉर्म अ थ्री डिमेंशनल क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर्स. थ्री डिमेंशनल्स मीन A, B एंड Z. यू नो द डिफरेंट लेंथ्स मैथ वॉल्यूम ईच थिंग आर इंक्लूडेड इन द थ्री डिमेंशनल क्रिस्टल डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड दीज आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट स्ट्रक्चर्स इन द इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री एज वेल एज द केमिस्ट्री होल केमिस्ट्री. ओके एंड एक्सप्लेन द थिंग्स लाइक देयर मेल्टिंग पॉइंट बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. आयनिक कंपाउंड्स मोस्टली फॉर्म द क्रिस्टल्स दैट आर द आयनिक क्रिस्टल्स एंड द थ्री डिमेंशनल क्रिस्टल लैटिस स्ट्रक्चर्स होते हैं दैट आर ऑल्सो सम स्पेशल प्रॉपर्टी दैट दे आर सराउंडेड बाई देयर अपोजिटली चार्ज आयन अट्रैक्ट टू ईच अदर वेरी स्ट्रांगली. एज अ रिजल्ट द आयनिक कंपाउंड हैव द हाइएस्ट मेल्टिंग पॉइंट एंड द बॉइलिंग पॉइंट. द कंपाउंड आर रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय द फॉर्मूला यूनिट्स. इट्स अ प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द कंपाउंड दैट दे विल बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय द फॉर्मूला यूनिट्स. NaCl इट्स अ फॉर्मूला यूनिट. KBr इज अ फॉर्मूला यूनिट. SuCuSO4 इट्स अ फॉर्मूला यूनिट. एंड द कोवलेंट कंपाउंड मोस्टली एग्जिस्ट इन द मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्म. ओके कोवलेंट फॉर्म जो होगी उनकी मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्म में होगी. अ मॉलिक्यूल इज अ ट्रू रिप्रेजेंटेड टू द कोवलेंट कंपाउंड एंड इट्स फॉर्मूला इज कॉल्ड द मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला H2O HCl H2SO4 CH4. दिस इज द मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्मूला. ओके दिस इज द लास्ट वन डेफिनेशन दैट इज अबाउट द मिक्सचर. मिक्सचर वट इज द मिक्सचर व्हेन टू आर द मोर एलिमेंट्स आर द कंपाउंड मिक्स बाय मिक्सअप फिजिकली without any fixed ratio they form a mixture. Okay, two or more than a, it means it distinguish the mixtures from the elements and physically because they are connectedly only physically not with the fixed ratio chemically only physically they are attached with the without any fixed ratio. So these are called the mixtures. On mixing up the component substance retain their own chemical identities and properties because there is no chemical reaction behind this taking place so they will retain their chemical properties. The mixture can be separated into the parent components by the physical methods such as the distillation, filtration, evaporation, crystallization and magnetization. Whatever you are using the method you will disconnect or the decompose the element into mixture into their constituent elements. You will get the exactly the constituent elements. Mixture have a uniform composition throughout. They are called the homogeneous. As we know the mixtures have the two forms, no? Homogeneous and the heterogeneous. If they are in the throughout same composition they are called the homogeneous mixture like a gasoline, ice cream, etc. And whereas the heterogeneous mixture are those mixture the compound which composition is not uniform throughout and its example is the soil, rock and the wood, etc. Okay. Now, in this slide, I have just short example of the comparison between the elements, compounds and the mixture. It's just for our ascensions that we can make a better understanding that what is the element, what is a compound, what is mixture. An element is made up of the identical atoms only. It's a distinguishing, na? So hear it with attention. And it can't be broken down into the two or more similar substances. Okay, and what we can do with the compound? A compound is made up of the two or more different element and can be broken down into the elements by the chemical method. Only by the chemical method we can break down this. And the mixture. Mixture is made up of the two or more substances mixed in any proportions. And for those substances retain their properties. Okay, existence. अब देखते हैं कि elements किस तरह से exist करते हैं, compound किस तरह से और mixture किस तरह से. Element exist on their own. Okay, they can retain their identity independently. They can easily retain. Okay, exist the compound form में होंगे क्योंकि because they are compound and the component element are present in the definite proportions in the compound. And what will be the existence in the mixtures? Components of the mixture are present in any proportions. There is no fixed ratio by the mass or not the because they are not chemically attached, just physically attached honge or they retain their identity properties. They have a definite set of the properties in the case of the element. They have also definite properties, set of properties in the case of the compound. But in the form of the mixture, they have no definite set of the properties. ओके एलिमेंट्स कैन बी सेपरेटेड बाय द केमिकल और फिजिकल मेथड. कंपाउंड्स कैन ऑल्सो कैन बी सेपरेटेड बाय द केमिकल और फिजिकल मेथड ओनली बाय द केमिकल मेथड. सॉरी हियर इज अ मिस्टेक. ओनली बाय द केमिकल मेथड एंड मिक्सचर आर इजिली मोस्ट इजिएस्ट वे टू सेपरेट इज द फिजिकल मेथड टू सेपरेट द मिक्सचर बिकॉज दे आर नॉट केमिकली बाउंड सो वी कैन ऑल्सो डिसकनेक्ट दैम. नो एग्जाम्पल्स लुक एट द एग्जाम्पल. एलिमेंटल फॉर्म में हमारे पास है क्या सोडियम आयरन कॉपर हाइड्रोजन ऑक्सीजन एंड द क्लोरीन एंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द कंपाउंड जिंक क्लोराइड वाटर एंड द नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड. ओके इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द मिक्सचर्स. मिक्सचर्स के हमारे पास क्या होते हैं कि पोटाशियम क्लोराइड सोल्यूशन सॉल्ट के फॉर्म में पाए जाते हैं. वाटर सॉल्ट होते हैं सैंड चॉक एंड वाटर ईटीसी. दीज आर द मिक्सचर्स वी कैन चेंज दैम. इफ यू मेक अ मिक्सचर ऑफ वाटर एंड द सैंड यू कैन ईजिली डिस्टिंग्विश दैट हेयर इज द बॉटम ऑफ बॉटम देयर विल बी द सैंड बिकॉज ड्यू टू इट्स हैवी डेंसिटी इट विल रेन्स डाउन एट द बॉटम there will be the sand and at the upper layer there is the water. Okay, there is a short question that always comes in a paper and it's a most frequently repeated question in the paper that what is the difference between the compound and mixture. Okay, I explained in the previous slide but I will also still explain it more. Okay, compound. It is formed by the chemical combination of the elements in the compound and the mixture is formed by the simply mixing of the substances. Constituents lose their identity and in the form of the mixture, they will not lose their identity. Compound kya hoti hai ki they have the fixed ratio but the mixture, they have no fixed ratio. The compound. Cannot be separated by the physical method but mixture can be separated by the physical method. Okay, in the compound, compound is represented by the chemical formula but the mixture is it consists of the two or more component and can have the chemical formula. Never have the chemical formula. Okay, now most towards the compound has a homogeneous composition and they may be homogeneous or heterogeneous because of their composition and they are the mixtures and the compound have the sharp melting and the boiling point but the mixture will not have the even melting point or boiling point that are the sharp. They can vary but change. Okay, here is a quiz for you guys. You have to just read the question and note down and just think or pause this video and check your talent. You can answer these questions because these are the simplest questions as I learned you about the what is the element, compound and a mixture. This is the just a to check your memory what you have heard what you have absorbed in yourself and what you will done. Okay, good luck.